Yes, thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you to the Fleming Conference Organization for the help and assistance. Here I represent European Medical Association, which is based in Brussels. It's an association of 50,000 medical doctors from all the European countries. The topic of this Fleming lecture is interaction between industry and healthcare professionals. Interaction means also communication. And in this perspective, transparency of relationship are extremely important. The core topic of this conference is corporate compliance of health industries. And I will say something regarding my personal point of view as a medical doctor in this respect. Thank you. Collaboration between healthcare industry and healthcare professionals. Of course, both stakeholders share information and experience. But the problems are related to the promotion, implementation, and assessment of best practice, the promotion of innovation, the facilitation of research and new ideas, and the way of skipping pitfalls. Participatory medicine issues. Of course, this is a very, very relevant problem, not only from the marketing point of view, but also from the epidemiological point of view. General population, patients, and advocacy groups and media are mostly important. As the representative of European Medical Association, I must stress this point. The priority of medical doctors is the unique shared ethical commitment they have. And this commitment, unique, is the patient, the single patient who is entrusted to each one medical doctor. This is a very relevant point for us. Industry and healthcare professionals may have some diverging aims, and this is a consequence of different analysis of unmet needs. So the first is to share methods of analysis. The second point is to share realistic goals. I know that there is a very relevant overlap of epidemiology, market, and attractiveness of product and professional features. In these subsets, anthropological and ethical issues overlap and are important. Concerns and actions of stakeholders interact in research, interact in regulations, interact in marketing, and interact at the level of final users that are both medical doctors, healthcare professionals, and patients. In this subset, the relevance of health providers, the management of public and private health institutions and organizations, the relevance of policymakers and the relevance of press and media must be taken into account with a great care. I have to address which are the most relevant barriers to more effective clinical practice. The current debate is, it is supposed that clinical trials have an inadequate logic from the point of view of medical practice. Most of us recognize limitations of translational features from lab to epidemiology and to clinical comprehensive approaches. Somebody feels that evidence-based medicine and several guidelines are almost a cage. We are in the search of novel established paradigms. We, as European Medical Association, strongly believe and understand that transparency and digitization adequacy is one very important element. Which is the alliance for the patient? Is evident. Transparency in medical doctor-patient relationship is a key and is supported by reciprocal trust. I would like to stress also some hidden problems. There is a qualitative contribution to health process from individual health professionals. It is not automatic. It is not only a matter of algorithms. It is very important. Actually, we live every day a misunderstanding from institutions of what is happening around us. There is an appeal from several parts, from several stakeholders, to non-medical, non-pharmaceutical, non-conventional approaches, which are addressed to health promotion, to prevention of disease, to care of disease. The problem is that there is a real proactive network of misleading or partial information providers. These networks are leading to counterfeit news and to counterproductive reactions. Everybody knows the current debate on no-vax, but other debates are very important and are a danger for patients. The wished outcomes of medicine, official medicine I mean, and medical doctors as medical associations must be visible and credible. The same for industry. This is possible through transparency of processes and transparency of interactions with all the components of the health process. Medical associations understand very well what means compliance to rules and compliance to commitments. Is an old ethical and professional tradition. The same is for industry. It's a more recent commitment, but it is important. Information and procedures should be reusable. This is possible only through an effective transparency. You know, in science, any experiment should be reproducible, the same in medical diagnostic and therapeutics. In the same condition, we should face the same type of effect. The same view can be used for transparency of processes and of interactions between health industry and health professionals. We have in mind the possible benefits of this approach for healthcare professionals and pharma industry. Benefits are for patients. This is the first priority for us. But there is also a beneficial effect for health systems and for specific providers, public or private, and for a national or international health system. Of course, must be recognized the benefits for pharma industry and for healthcare professionals. I will address and focus these last points. Even if digitization of industry research and development innovation is already present, the extent of shared transparency is still limited. Worldwide, nationwide, and even segmental, regional transparency is very limited. The view of the European Medical Association is that we can reshape knowledge, practice, and innovation in medicine, certainly by the attendance at to congresses and to other educational events, such as here. But we need also transferring effectively knowledge, and we need also triggering new ideas and new challenges. An approach similar to nudge strategy maybe is relevant, and also the choice of the most suitable default effects are important. In brief, factors that may enhance, maintain, or weaken respective leadership positions within healthcare professional and pharma-driven lines of research are science, practice, academy, and market. This is an important topic: leadership in practicing medicine, leadership in pharma industry. A leadership based on good science, good practice, good academical teaching, and good and well-compliant market is really a very respectful compliance. respective interests useful to achieve or increase leadership in pharma and in health professions should be explicit, should be without conflict of interest, and involvement of conventional media, social media, and regulatory actors should be with full disclosure. Last but not least, the use of intrusive breaking privacy tools should be carefully addressed and regulated. What we think, European Medical Association, we think that better informed medical doctors make better treated patients. This is a very important point. Equally, we think that traceability is a major topic in relationship between all the stakeholders and media is important. This point of view has some contradiction with the need of a full regulatory compliance of pharma and health organization, with the requirement of transparency, with the respect of privacy. Both medical doctors and patients are jealous guardians of privacy, because information regarding health and disease may be used for business purposes. This is not the case of medical doctor. For a legal problem and for an ethical problem, but also for a marketing problem, because patients escape from medical doctors not respecting their privacy and their confidentiality. Patients escape if it is possible for them to escape, of course, in a free health system. There is an asymmetry in knowledge and in the operational possibility between pharma and device industry and healthcare professional. Healthcare professionals are the only totally authorized to interact with population of healthy and sick persons. The strength in implementation process and outcome assessment and the detection of the quality of healthcare delivery is not a matter only of healthcare professional, but there is probably a greater qualification. Sources and dissemination of information should be filtered, in my view, and validated by medical science, by scientific methodology. And also this strategy aimed at enhancing and translating into practice the effects of evidence-based knowledge and innovation is a task exclusive of healthcare professionals. This is a very long list of what we need for enhance technology in planning and conduct of clinical trials. And this is a comparison of several items addressing how pharmaceutical industry has been cautious about moving into the digital space. Differently, opinion leaders, doctors, therapists, and patients increasingly communicate in several digital domains when, seemingly, pharma is still a marginal part of this dialectic process. This is not a good part of our world of healthcare and pharma industry interactions. Thank you for having assisted me, all the colleagues of the organization of the conference, and now the discussion is open to your questions. Thank you. Thank you.